Welcome back to St Mary's for the start of season three. It's been a busy summer, so let's go and have a look at the ins and outs. It has been a really quite busy summer, so there's a lot to get through, so I should start without delay. Now, first man out the door was Jack Bycroft for less than 500 quid. Really backup goalkeeper, I think. Can't even quite remember. Next one to leave was the Moroccan lad that we signed a couple of years ago, Selim Amala, who had slipped down the pecking order, and we got 3.2 million for him from Stoke. I'm kind of happy with that. Now, Juan Larios has gone back out on loan. He's at Luton this time. He's still lurking around as our third choice left back, so I thought rather than leave him sitting there and almost never playing, he'd go to Luton, play some games. A couple of days after that, talking of left backs, Romain Perrault went to Switzerland, young boys, 5 million, and I've been umming and ahhing about getting rid of Romain Perrault for a good season, and finally decided to go through with it. And we will have a look at his replacement shortly. And also another one that honestly I've been looking to probably get rid of since he started, Adam Armstrong, who as a real life Saints fan I really don't see the point in. Yeah, he has gone to Brest for 2.5 million, which just shows you how little he's done for the last 2 years, because I mean that's almost nothing, quite frankly. Not almost nothing was Duje Chaletta-Sarr, who has left us for 12.25 million. He went out on loan, you might remember, last season, and Sporting had the option to buy. I don't know if it was an optional mandatory fee, but yeah, came through with said fee. But it was a nice boost to our transfer kitty. Unlundulu and Simeu were basically players who we released because we didn't feel they were good enough for us. Now, Simeu was interesting because I looked at him and I thought, ooh, he'd be quite good for Portsmouth. And yeah, he would, but Portsmouth can't afford him. I don't know what wage he's on at Strasbourg. 310,000, yeah, that is pushing it for that Portsmouth. Now, Pafe Cisse, another first season signing who has gone. Huesca, who had our Uruguayan lad, whose name I can't quite remember off the top of my head, on loan last season, have stumped up 10 million for Pafe Cisse, who again was sort of dropping down the pecking order. Nathan Teller, who was just never looking good enough. Scouting coaches always told me he was a Premier League level talent, but I honestly, in his attributes, I couldn't see it. So 6 million, he's gone to Spain, Tenerife. Most of the rest are loans. Until we get to the bottom here, when all of a sudden I was questioning whether I wanted to try and improve on Edozie. He plays left wing. Obviously, we have Shelder up there, who is fantastic. And I was questioning whether I wanted Edozie as his backup, whether I was happy with him as his backup or not. Then all of a sudden, West Ham come in with a bid, and I think Edozie said he would be unsettled if I didn't let him speak to them. At which point, of course, I've got to go out and find another left back, a left winger, rather, so I can say, yeah, all right, have him. Pushed him up to 27.5 million, and we did get his replacement, and I think his replacement is at least as good, if not slightly better. And finally, left 2 days ago for a Watford side that we play in 3 days' time, Jan Bednarek, who that first season I was here, I was missing him. I didn't know why we let him go. And I believe in real life we have actually recalled him from loan at Aston Villa. And then he came back last season and just disappointed quite a lot. And again, I think we have at least upgraded, or at least matched, if not upgraded, probably younger talent that might get a little better than Jan Bednarek was. So, one last little thing before we deal with the ins. Sekou Keita, he had been on out on loan at QPR last season. They have now come in with a non-negotiable £4 million bid for him, which I have just accepted, so he will probably be out the door. But, you know, £4 million's £4 million, isn't it? Now, as you can see, we have been spending a bit of money. Now, you might remember I was coveting a young Brazilian goalkeeper last summer. Darub, I think his name is, who I couldn't get because we'd already signed too many youngsters. And then I was like, okay, we'll wait a year. I'll get him next summer. And then Andre Gomes appeared on the horizon. And, I mean, that is about as solid on the technicals for a goalkeeper as you want for someone who's 19. Physically, good. Mentally, needs to improve a bit, but he's 19. He will improve mentally. I mean, it says there, League 2 standard player. If I was in League 2 and I had a goalkeeper like that, I wouldn't expect to concede a goal. Fairly professional, potentially Premier League standard, consistent. Basically, he is going to push Bazunu down into third place, because if we get an injury to Livakovic, Andre Gomes is going in. And he was, what, 6.5 rising to 7.25. So, basically, dirt cheap. Benfica have robbed you blind. Bayern Munich sold us Jamie Lawrence. Name like that, obviously German. Again, lots of lovely blue, couple of green numbers in there. Good quality centre-back, 21 years old. And again, this is why I've got no real problem with Bednarek going. Because Lawrence is probably, maybe not quite as good as him at the moment, but he's got a lot of potential. He's going to be good. Again, potential Premier League standard. Says he's Championship at the moment. Another German lad, Noel Aseko Unkili, who, again, sounds very German. 18 years old. Signed from, well, Bayern's reserve side, apparently. And, yeah, this one set us back 19.25 million. But, again, I mean, we've switched to a deep-line playmaker in central midfield. I'll show you the Saints' tactic in a little bit, because it has changed a bit, which caused me an awful lot of problems, which we'll come to in a minute. But, again, plenty of blue numbers, physically good. At the age of 18, I mean, he's that good at the age of 18. So, and those mentals will come on. Technically, he's decent. Resolute personality, which is great. And a very good pickup. Now, Keanu Lorenzo, who I did kind of have... Well, actually, no. I thought I had him earmarked as a left wing. I keep on making this mistake with Keanu Lorenzo. He's actually on our right side because he is left-footed. Of course, we play inverted winger on the left and inside forward now on the right. But, again, Benfica B. So, they're this summer's victims. Last year it was it Dinamo Zagreb? Benfica B this time. And, again, 19 years old. Plenty of room for improvement. Cuts inside from right wing. Perfect for the inside forward position we want him to play eventually. So, probably not going to get a lot of game time unless someone does come in with a good loan offer for him. But we might bung him into a few things. And he'll probably play in, like, Papa John's. Now, this one, another 19 million. Vitor Roque, wonder kid. 19 years old. Quick as. Mentally very good at this age. Technically good. I mean, the boy is going to be an absolute beast. I've got him on the bench for our opening game, which is at Anfield, by the way. And I am almost certainly going to be bringing him on at some point. I want to see him. I haven't seen him play yet since we got him. Because as you can see from his stats here, he's been at the Olympic Games with Brazil. So, yeah, we haven't actually seen him play yet. But we hope to rectify that later today. Now... Tiango Nianzu was the culmination of a very long and fraught search, because I have changed our tactics, as I said, and there was one position in it that was causing me all sorts of problems, because we now play with a libero. And I had Kivior, who was our best option at libero. None of the others were really suitable. They didn't have the technical and sort of attacking ability that you need as a libero. And oh, I went through so many players trying to find one. And it was either they didn't want to come, they were going to be too expensive, their wages were sky high, all sorts of things stopping deals going through. Finally found Tanguy Nianzou at Sevilla, £11 million. Wage is quite high for us, but I mean, he's worth three times what we paid for him already. And I mean, look at these attributes. He is quality. He's 22. He's our starting libero. Now, Sergio Arribas here is Edozie's replacement. Now, you might remember we sold Edozie for 27.5 million. We signed Arribas from Castilla, which is like Real Madrid B team, 1.7 million. And on a wage of just over 1 million. And, I mean, the boy is gifted. I don't know if I can compare him with... No, I probably can't now, because Edozie's not here anymore. But yeah, I mean, he's every bit as good as Edozie is. He's a good championship player already. So, yeah, he is... I mean, he's not going to get a huge amount of game time as long as Sheldrup stays fit. But he is very, very handy to have hanging around. And our final signing, with light to the fact that people were after Bednarek, I needed another centre-back, because obviously we now play three at the back, so I need like six. And we found Omar Alderete, Paraguayan, 12 million from Hertha. Apparently 12 million is the most ever paid for a Paraguayan. So we've made history with this one. Those technicals that count, green, positioning, green. I mean, everything, all the major attributes are green. Several of the secondaries are. I mean, the boy is quality. Loves big matches, consistent. I mean, he is going to be a good player in this squad, I think. And, I mean, that is an upgrade on Bednarek in my money. So, that's all the ins and outs. I did promise you a look at our tactics. Here we are. Livakovic is just down as a normal goalkeeper now. Actually, that's a point. I think I'm still training him as sweeper keeper. And I have got them down. I'll have to try and remember to do that. Now we play two normal centre-backs, not the ball-playing centre-backs we did play, because that job is now done by the libero. They are solely responsible for spraying the ball out from the back. And I think actually Nianzou, one of his... we're training him on likes to switch ball to wide areas. So what we're hoping is the ball gets to him and then he sort of pings it to Dowell or Sheldrup. Now, we've pushed our fullbacks who were on attack last season up to wingbacks but on defence. So they're probably kind of going to be doing roughly the same sort of thing, because obviously a wingback will get forward a bit more, but they're going to be looking a bit more defensively as well. So hopefully we'll be defensively solid. Central midfield, Ward-Prowse doing the box-to-box still, trying to burst in there. Lavia, hopefully picking out those passes. We've got, obviously, Libero looking to do that as well. So we've got a couple of creative outlets. Change the right-hand side to inside forward, which suits Dowell pretty well. Sheldrup, we converted to inverted winger, because it's basically what he's best at. And you don't have all that green and wasted. So... that's what we're doing. I mean, basically, apart from his penalty taking, which, you know, isn't involved in any of this stuff anyway, that's just there. But every green attribute is used as an inverted winger, so I'm happy that he's getting the best out of him. Now, we've gone complete forward up front, and Balogun is getting the nod ahead of Che Adams, who's just signed a new four-year deal and has basically just lost his starting spot. And obviously with Vitor Roque coming in as well, I mean, Che is possibly even third choice now. So it might just be that in January we have a look around and see if anyone's prepared to offer us some decent money for Che. Because I can't see him having a long future here anymore. Anyway, that is enough of that. As you can see from the friendlies, won the lot, played a few American sides, which were lower scoring and Exeter, but comfortable wins nonetheless. Destroyed Andover 16-0. A couple of other weaker sides, but couldn't get much more of a contrast, could it? Trip to Anfield, and I mean, this start of the season, away Anfield, midweek, home, our bete noire, bloody Watford. And then we played the other Merseyside team, Everton. So, it's a tricky start, but we will see what happens. We're on TV, so let's get to it. Right, Anfield. Starting lineup: Livakovic, Livramento, Bella Kochap, Sutalo, Yilmaz. Valeri has been injured for most of the preseason, so he's only on the bench. Nianzou, Ward-Prowse, Lavia, Dowell, because Aribo is also out injured, Shelderup and Balogun. Now, here we go. Enjoy, play with no pressure, boys. It's all on them. They're expected to beat us easily. So, let's see what we can do. We did have a fantastic result against Liverpool last season, didn't we? I think it was at St Mary's we beat them 3-2, did we? Pretty sure we beat them last season at some point. See how we go with this sort of kind of three, kind of five at the back. Okay. Bella Kochap, Ward-Prowse, oh yeah, Dowell, Livramento. Knocking it about confidently. Lavia, who's our midfield playmaker. And Nianzou, of course, our defensive sort of playmaker. Shelderup. Oh no. Now, see, that's kind of one of the things I wanted Nianzou there to do as well. Cover that ball over the top, through the middle, that catches us out so much. And hopefully with him there... Oh, they've worked that well. Can't really do much about that when he's gone to close someone else down and they just basically pass through us. All right, there's hope. Oh, it's been disallowed. Trent Alexander-Armstrong. Who was this offside? Oh, was that? Yeah, Salah. Brilliant. Well, that's a bit of a reprieve. Not getting shots on target again, boys. Not getting completely dominated. I mean, they've had the better of it, obviously. They're supposed to. Oh, finally a shot on target. Not a good one, but it was a shot. All right, go on. Letting him get away with a couple of dodgy touches there. Probably could have let him. Oh my God, Livakovic. Let's not do that again, son. Yeah? Oh God, do I want to watch this again? I mean, there's no reason to be playing it where you did. I mean, what? Just hoof it. I mean, Diogo Jota's giving it all that, running away. You didn't do anything to get that goal, son. It hit you. Basically. You didn't have much choice about scoring that. No, he's offside. He's offside. He's offside. Flag up, son. Flag up. Come on, he was off. Oh, Lino, you balls that one up, haven't you? Yet again, us buggering about and giving it away. Oh, for God's sake, is that you? Oh, Sutalo. Right, fine, okay, he wasn't off then. Right, you're playing rubbish. I know they're good, but you have gifted them two goals. Don't. All I ask of you is don't. Right, come on, boys. Let's There you go. Remember, you're playing in the sort of whitish sort of shirts. Hello. Darren England was given a penalty. You watch this get overturned on VAR. No. Right. JWP, come on. Presume you're on penalty duty. You are. And as he dinked it again, he did that. He did a little Panenka penalty in the off season in the friendlies. No, he just sort of, I don't know what Alisson was doing there. He could have caught that, quite frankly. Right, we said we'd give Roque a look. He's come back match sharp, hasn't he? I'll give that for the Brazilians. They used him well in the Olympics. Right, Valeri's going to have to come on because Yilmaz is threatening to be utter rubbish. Sheldrup's not playing brilliantly. Defence generally isn't playing that well. Let's give Alderete, who's also match sharp, a bit of a run out. Right, let's leave it at the triple subage for the moment. Come on, boys. Have a bit of encouragement. I mean, 2-1, honestly, I wouldn't be offended if we lost 2-1 when we are supposed to be considerably worse than this lot. I mean, much more than 2-1. I mean, we have... Oh, I thought you were going to do it again for a minute there. We do have a nasty habit, boys, of giving them the ball somewhere like 25 yards from goal and just saying, go for it. Or indeed closer, Livakovic. Alderete. Good header. And then, is he offside? Please tell me he's offside. Put your flag up. Come on, mate. Exercise your arm. Oh, for God's sake. That Lino's got it. He's in for us, hasn't he? Not giving anything. I realise it's probably the one up the other end last time, but... just shout, demand more. It's not going to do anything. Oh, don't. You did this last time, Liverpool. You got a 4-1 win that you did not bloody earn. Quite wrong, you haven't earned this one. We've given it to you. We could stop giving you the ball 2 yards from goal. Might have drawn this. Good save, Livakovic. Doesn't make up for the goal, but good save. I mean, even with what he did there, he's still playing a 6.7. Oh, my Lord. That was nearly 4, wasn't it? Still could be. Hello, Valeri. Good lad. Well, that was an object lesson in how not to play against a top side in your own final third, wasn't it, really? Yeah, I'm not happy with the performance. I'm not going to, you know, pat you on the head and say, oh, well done, you did your best. Because that, clearly, was not your best. If that's your best, we're in for a long, hard season. Probably are anyway, but that's not the point. Oh, good. I get the joys of Watford next as well. Hooray! I love playing Watford. Because, you know, there's no bias of SI towards Watford at all. Is there, Miles? What's that? Miles supports Watford, you say? Well, just get that quiet. Well, we always knew free hits, as they say. We knew we were going to start season... with a defeat. The season starts on Wednesday. So, shall we look at the league table? Why not? God, I hate it when you have to scroll down to find yourself. Well, we are in the relegation zone, but at least we're not Wolves. You've got panned 6 by Chelsea. And we did kind of gift Liverpool 2 goals, didn't we? So, you know. Charitable. We used to give them players, now we just give them goals. Right, well, it wasn't the best of starts, but like we said, it was a free hit. So, we will rattle on with a bit of the season and see where we get to. But, thank you for joining me. Like, comment, subscribe, and for now, I will see you next time. Bye-bye.